Hello friends, so in this tutorial we'll be resuming where we left. So as you already know, we were successfully, we added the data successfully in the table, employees table, you can see here, right? So the next task would be we are going to display the data in the table, right? So let's go to the editor here. So this was the function what we have used in order to add the data, right? So now we need to display the data in our HTML, right? So I'll just quickly add a function here, what we have used initially. So the function name was display employee data, right? So we'll quickly add the data here. Now what I said, as I said, in the previous videos, it would be real time, right? So we need to follow some basic instructions in order to achieve the goal. So I'll just quickly reference out the employees tables, a reference here. I'll just take it out, and I'll be using on method, right? On would be, it's kind of a real time function or method, right? There are two different methods what we have in Firebase. So one is once and other one would be on. Once will only work when you get on the page, right? Suppose for example, if I'm accessing this page, right? If I reload the page, so after reloading the page, the data what we see, we will get only once. Or if we click, then we can call the once method. So it'll only works when we call it. But with on method, it's totally different case. It's a totally different case. So what we can do, we can bind events with this method where we can ask this method to look for any changes, right, in the database. For example, we can use the on method in order to check if the child has been added to the database. As soon as the new child gets added to the database, this function would trigger. You don't have to trigger it manually. It will be triggered automatically because we are using child added event, right? So it will work, in a different way of what we use in, with once, all right? So now what we need to do, we need to just create the response here, what we get. So let's console it out, right? Let's console it out first. So you guys can see what we are getting from the database. All right, so we will be consoling the data. I'll just save it, and I'll quickly reload the page, and I'll go to the inspect. So when I inspected, when I checked, so I get one object here. So this is the object what we have in the database, right? See, this is the employee's data. And what we are getting here, we're getting the exact same object, right? So if we add a new data, let's add one more data. We don't have to refresh the page. We'll get the operations data right away in the console. All right, so I'll quickly add one more data. Okay, I'll give any name. So it's p@gmail.com. Similarly, address teststreet once again. And this phone number, any random number you can give. All right, I'll just quickly click on add. So I triggered the event, right? You can see we instantly got the data here, and instantly it will be added in the Firebase table. Right, so this is what a real-time database, this is how the real-time database work. All right, so now we have successfully consoled the data. Now what we need to do, we need to display it on our page. So on the top, we will just add one variable called new underscore HTML, and we will initialize it like this. Okay, because we'll be binding the HTML to this variable. Okay, so what we are going to do, we need to bind a table to this variable, because in our view, in the HTML view, we have a table. So we need to bind this data to the body, right? Then only we can achieve what we want to. All right. So let's create the data here. So plus equal to, and we're going to add dynamic HTML to this variable. We are going to add dynamic HTML to this variable. So first we need to add a row. All right. We just need to add one row and multiple columns. Okay. So we just say tr ID. So for every row, there will be a unique ID. And how we'll get the unique ID? We'll get the unique ID from the database itself, because we have created one. Okay. So, So we'll just give any random ID to this. Not the random one, we will fetch the ID from the database. Okay, so this is gonna be the tr of the table. All right, so we have just added the tr. All right, so here it is. And in this, in these two double quotes, we will add employee data dot val, okay, dot emp ID, what we have created. All right, so you will see this would be working fine. Okay, so then new HTML. Again, we are going to add new HTML here, and similarly, we are going to create a TD. All right, we are going to create a TD here. Okay, okay. So there's one more mistake I have here. I need to, bind this to this one. Okay. And we'll just remove this one. Okay. All right. Let's do it one more time. I guess I'm doing something wrong here. So we'll create a tr. Okay. And here in this tr, we need to add ID. Okay. ID we are going to add here. So. Okay, now it's fine, I guess. Yeah, it's fine. So we will add employee data dot val and dot emp ID. So it's fine, right? Similarly, now the row has been started. We'll just close the row here itself. Okay, so we need to close tr. Okay, we have closed it perfectly. Now we need to add the columns. So how many columns do we have? We have So we have like five columns, so we need to add five columns here. So I'll just quickly add one here, and we will create the rest of them too. So here we need to add TD, right? We need to create a TD here, and then in the TD we need to provide the data, right? We need to provide the data, so we will be using ID here. Okay, so ID, I'll tell you why we are going to use the ID here. So we'll just add the ID, and we will call it name underscore. Okay, so we'll be binding the values here. Okay, so here I'll just add plus emp data dot val. Okay, dot EMP, I guess it was name in the database, so we'll use name. All right, so this is how we create a column, and we don't need to do much here. So yeah, for the ID we'll be using ID, not the name. Okay, so we need to display the name here, right? So in order to display the name, what we can do, we need to add the name here. So we'll close the TD here. Okay, so as you can see, I have closed the TD. So here in the TD, we need to add the values, right? So we will quickly add the values by adding employee data dot val. What we are adding here, we are adding name. Okay, let's check it out what we get. Okay, I'll just refresh the page. Okay, right now we don't get anything because we didn't completed the binding part. So what we need to do in order to complete the binding part, we just need to use one trick. It's HTML. We need to bind it to the HTML, right? So we need to get the ID of the table. Okay, we need to get the ID of the table, and what we are going to bind, we are going to bind new HTML. So we'll check the ID. What ID I have given, I don't remember actually. Okay, where is the ID, dude? Yeah, this is the table, and here we are going to add, because we'll be binding the values to the employee table, right? So body would be the perfect way to, the perfect place to bind the values. So let's save it out, and we'll go back to our page. And do we get anything? No. Okay. Yeah, we are getting. All right, we have got the data here. Only one row we have, I mean, only one column we have got. So similarly, we need to get all the columns. So I'll quickly add all the columns. All right, guys. So you can see I have added rest of the columns too. But similarly, I have added a few more things. Let me explain you how what. So I'll delete these things, right? I'll delete it for you. Why? I'll tell you the reason. So first of all, what we have all the data here, right? So let's check it out. Refresh the page. And data, yeah, we're getting the data. So I have given one extra column here. I call it actions. So what actions we are going to perform? We're going to perform edit operation as well as delete operation, right? So in this video, I have covered the display operation. We are reading the data out, right? So we have created and we have read the data. So now in the next tutorial, we are going to edit or delete the data similarly. Right, so as soon as, let me add one more value, let's see what happens here. Okay, testing. Okay, so we'll add the data, boom, right away it's there on your page, right? We didn't refresh the page, we didn't reload the page or anything. It's added here in the table, it's added here in the HTML as well, right? So this is how we actually create a real-time application. So I'll see you in the next part. Where we are going to cover the edit or delete action, right? So I'll see you there.